On October the 11th, 2020, at about 2 a.m. local time, the city of Ganja in the Republic of Azerbaijan was attacked by the fascist Armenian armed forces. The missiles launched from the fascist Armenian government against the city of Ganja are a crime against humanity, are a violation of human rights, and the European Union must take immediate action to sanction all of the leadership in Armenia and in the occupied territories of the Republic of Azerbaijan. The Armenian leadership must be held accountable for these atrocities and for killing over 50 people, among them children and women. About 205 apartments in the central district of Ganja have been destroyed from the missiles launched from the Armenian armed forces. At the same time, the Armenian leadership in Kankendi, in the occupied city of Kankendi, inside the sovereign territory of Azerbaijan, must be held accountable and they should be brought in front of the International Court of Justice. At the same time, we have to condemn, as an international community, we have to condemn the traffic of weapons, the weapons trafficking and the weapons transportation through airlines, through civilian airlines to the Republic of Armenia. At this time, we know once again that Armenia is not a reliable negotiator, is simply instigating violence, destruction, and violating the UN Security Council resolutions in the heart of Europe. Europe must not be quiet. Europe, European Union, and the European Council should take immediate actions to condemn the terrorist government of Armenia, incur and apply economic sanctions against Armenia until Yerevan has withdrawn all of its armed forces from the sovereign territory of Azerbaijan. Once again, on October the 11th, we have another testimony, another clear and lucid testimony of what President Ilham Aliyev has been saying all this time, during all this time, that the Armenians are not willing to negotiate. They simply want to hold hostage 20% of the sovereign territory of Azerbaijan. On the other hand, the President of Azerbaijan, His Excellency Mr. Ilham Aliyev, has shown a great level of leadership, wisdom, and courage to liberate all of the sovereign territory of Azerbaijan and at the same time preserve democratic values and promote human rights, while the sovereign territory of Azerbaijan is being liberated. Now we have the district of Fizuli and Tartar and Agdam that have been liberated, and in this context, these actions must be commended from the international community.
Hello, my name is Fatimaya. I'm from Kyrgyzstan. I want all people worldwide to know the truth about what happened in Ganja on the 11th of October. Armenia and Azerbaijan signed a ceasefire on the 10th of October. In spite of this, Armenian armed force on the 11th of October had fired upon the city of Ganja with a Scud missile. During the attack, significant infrastructure, namely 31 apartment buildings, were completely destroyed. Attack affects 205 people, living in total of 95 departments. As a result of the attack, 10 people were killed and 40 people were injured, with women and children being among the victims. Armenia repeated a missile attack on the city of Ganja on the 17th of October. Journalists reported 3 powerful explosions in the town. 20 houses were destroyed. According to the initial reports, certain people were killed and more than 52 people were injured. Armenia denied responsibility for these attacks. I want all people to know the truth. But firstly, I want to express my condolences for all people, for all civilians of Ganja who lost their loved ones in these attacks. I also want to express my support toward all Azerbaijani people. Stop Armenian aggression. Stop Armenian terror.
Hello, my name is Clement Awanfe. I am a member of Young Friends of Azerbaijan from Cameroon. It is very sad to hear that Azerbaijan is facing one of the unacceptable atrocities in the region of Karabakh and now in Ganja City. I call the international community to do something to bring back peace in those regions of Azerbaijan. I also highly condemn the Armenian aggressions to the Azerbaijani people. I visited Azerbaijan, I know the country, and I know people of Azerbaijan are very welcoming. They are peaceful people. The recent aggression of Ganja City shows exactly that Armenia is not seeking peace in the region. We call the international community to seriously involve and find the right way and look for the truth to bring back peace, and starting from a ceasefire, because people are dying and infrastructure are getting destroyed. I watch the news on TV and it is very sad. It is really unacceptable what is happening in Karabakh region.
Friends, as you all know, 2 days ago, Armenian army attacked Azerbaijan's second largest city Ganja. The targets were civilians. I hope that whole international community will be against this aggression and they will start support Azerbaijan. My country, Croatia, also suffered 25 years ago same this aggression. I hope that things will be better and this aggression will be stopped.
Меня зовут Кончарук Марина, я представитель украинской молодежи, и я, как и весь наш украинский народ, искренне поддерживаю Азербайджан и азербайджанский народ в их борьбе за территориальную целостность, за восстановление территориальной целостности. Ведь согласно международному праву, Карабах и 7 прилегающих регионов – это исконно азербайджанские территории, и я искренне верю, что закон будет восстановлен, и азербайджанцы вернутся на те земли, откуда их изгнали впоследствии армянской военной агрессии. Мне очень жаль и очень больно читать информацию про то, что армянские вооруженные силы обстреливают мирные города Азербайджана. Но я искренне верю в то, что те, кто совершает эти тяжкие преступления, они понесут наказание за эти действия согласно международному праву. Но я очень рада, что украинский народ, он всегда поддерживал Азербайджан. И я очень рада, что Украина в такой трудный момент для Азербайджана на официальном уровне выразила поддержку Азербайджану. Я искренне верю, что восстановится территориальная целостность Азербайджана, что азербайджанцы вернутся на свои родные земли, и что мир и закон восстановятся на тех территориях. Я, как и многие представители украинской молодежи, активно принимаю участие в популяризации исторических реалий про Нагорно-Карабахский конфликт, информирование украинцев про правдивую информацию про события в Нагорном Карабахе. И я думаю, что украинское общество, оно искренне поддерживает Азербайджан, о чем свидетельствует много шагов, в том числе на официальном уровне. Мы поддерживаем Азербайджан и абсолютно уверенно заявляем, что Карабах – это Азербайджан.
Hello everyone, my name is Regina and I'm from Estonia. I think you know about the conflict between Azerbaijan and Armenia, which is happening on the region of Nagorno-Karabakh. But my speech won't be directly about this. Several days ago, Armenia has blatantly violated the ceasefire regime and has attacked an innocent civilians in Ganja city, which is the second biggest city in Azerbaijan. If you will check where is located Ganja, you will find out that it's located quite far from the Karabakh region. What is more, if you will check which cities last month Armenia has attacked, you will get that all of them are located far from the conflict point. And even some of the cities are located near Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan. What Armenia does gratefully is killing Azerbaijani civilians. And Armenia even doesn't hide its aggression. I kindly ask you, don't believe Armenian propaganda. While Azerbaijan is under attack and the civilians who are living there are suffering and are injured, Azerbaijan has never attacked back Armenian peaceful cities. Because Azerbaijan can be an aggressor, and it shows every time that it's not like that. Karabakh is the region of Azerbaijan, and Azerbaijan always will keep it, and will never show the aggression. And doesn't matter it is Armenia or other country. Azerbaijan is a peaceful country. And everything what wants this republic is just liberate their lands.
Ganja ist mit seinen ca. 325.000 Einwohnern die zweitgrößte Stadt Aserbaidschans und liegt nicht im umkämpften Gebiet Bergkarabach. Anhaltende Bombardierungen dieser Stadt durch die Republik Armenien belegen gleich mehrere Qualitäten ihrer Haltung zum Bergkarabach-Konflikt. Sie ignoriert damit die Grenzen Aserbaidschans, die es eigentlich selbst anerkennt, und mischt sich so gesehen und auch völkerrechtlich gesehen in einen Konflikt innerhalb des Territoriums Aserbaidschans und somit in einen Bürgerkrieg in Aserbaidschan ein. Sie nimmt dadurch in Kauf, dass dieser Konflikt in einem bilateralen Krieg zwischen den Republiken Armenien und Aserbaidschan entartet und ferner durch Militärbündnis verknüpfte Staaten mit in diesen Konflikt einbezogen werden. Des Weiteren zeigt sich auch, dass sie zur Durchsetzung ihrer eigenen Interessen zivile Opfer in Kauf nimmt. Es ist anzumerken, dass eine Separation Bergkarabachs keine langfristig friedliche Lösung ist, sondern lediglich eine nationalistisch-irredentistische Option, die langfristig auch nur für mehr Konfliktpotenzial oder gar Konflikten in dieser multiethnisch geprägten Region beitragen wird.
Добрий день, мене звати Юлія Гупалюк, я молода поетка і студентка Київського національного університету імені Тараса Шевченка. У цьому відео хочу висловити свою публічну підтримку Азербайджану і азербайджанському народу у зв'язку з подіями, які зараз там відбуваються. Коли відбувається таке нахабне порушення норм міжнародного права, коли відбувається війна, ми, зокрема молодь і всі свідомі громадяни не можемо мовчати. Ми маємо висловлювати свою позицію. Тому я закликаю всіх доєднатися до цього флешмобу, записати свої відео, де ви будете висловлювати свою позицію і закликаю всіх бути на боці норм міжнародного права, на боці справедливості і правди. А Азербайджану я бажаю якнайшвидшого миру і спокою. Дякую.
Hello everyone, my name is João Mestre. I'm from Portugal and I'm here to express my feelings for Azerbaijan and the events that are happening in Azerbaijan during these last few days. As you know, Azerbaijan is under rocket attack of Armenian forces. 4 days ago, Armenia has launched a lot of rockets through Azerbaijan, Ganja city, the second largest city in Azerbaijan of the Republic of Azerbaijan. And I'm really sad about this, seeing that a great country as Azerbaijan is under attack. Because we all know about the conflict that is happening, actually between Azerbaijan and Armenia. But I think, like, with politics and with talk, that is exactly what Azerbaijan always told us, to talk, never conflict and avoid conflict. I think the Republic of Azerbaijan and Armenia can reach a deal and can try to solve the problem. This is really important nowadays because we live in a peaceful world and the Republic of Azerbaijan is one of the great examples of a peaceful country. I've been there more than 4 times between summers and winter schools, and I think it's really important to all of us share this video and share our gratitude for Azerbaijan and everything that Azerbaijan would need. I'm here to express my gratitude and to provide every single second of help. Just call me, just say everything you want. I'll try as fast as I can to provide the help, and I highly hope that this video can provide a lot of help just for you and for my Azerbaijani friends, all the great people that I met during my visits to Azerbaijan. There were a lot of good people, a lot of multicultural people. That is what Azerbaijan is made from, the multicultural development and the richness of the culture, everything that a person like me has faced, has experienced every single time I stepped in the Republic of Azerbaijan territory. I was every single day more than welcomed by the Azerbaijan people, and I'm really glad to be part of the Azerbaijan family. I feel that I'm Portuguese as I am Azerbaijani. So I really, really hope this conflict solves, it goes to an end, and Armenia forces stop damaging the one of the richest cultures in the world, that is Azerbaijan. Okay, Azerbaijan is the middle point between Europe and Asia, and it's really important to keep the culture. Okay, Armenia is making a terrible mistake. Okay, so I'm making this video essentially to say that Portugal, as European countries, as the rest of the world, are with Azerbaijan, okay? But especially Portugal. I'm talking not just by myself, but all my friends from Portugal, all the people I know from Portugal. I hope this video reaches the right people, because it's really important to stay alongside Azerbaijan, as Azerbaijan did every single day since ever. Thank you very much.